Hi everyone, welcome once again to the channel. It's your boy Lewis, and today we're gonna be talking about my asawa, Josh Cullen, who is dropping his debut single and music video for Wild Tonight. Of course, we all know him as Josh from SB19, but as you guys know, gradually for the past few months, I will say, some of the boys have been dropping their debut singles and solo projects, so we get to see a little bit of the artistry in each one of them. Just the other day, we were talking about Philip, before that, we were talking about Pablo, and right now, it's time for Josh. So, for this video, this is my first time watching the video and listening to the song. So, of course, I'll give you my comments and feedback about everything that we're about to witness. As usual, make this an interactive experience, so let me know in the comment section what do you think as well. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to support the channel by dropping a like and subscribing, of course. I have a feeling this is gonna be a good one, so make sure that you watch until the end. I will see you right after the intro. Be strong. All right, here we go. I have my coffee and lip balm. That's the tradition here. So I'm ready. Impress me, Josh. Oh, I see evil eyes already, and a girl running away from a predator? Maybe? Wild Tonight. Okay, here we go. Pusta, hindi ka na ba? Ganun pa rin ba? Sa dito ko man wala. Pusta, hindi mo inakala. Ako'y magigising niya kasi yung pagkakabala. Nag-aabang magkamali. I need more volume. Nakamasit lahat pero sandali. Hindi ako tumatanda. Hindi kayo hindi nagtatanda. Sa hindi ko libingan na nga. First, one of my theories about the music video has just been confirmed, and that is that this is a vampire theme type of music video. I know that he dropped a few teasers before releasing the entire music video, but honestly, just for the purpose of not spoiling anything, I stayed away from most of the teasers. But I was getting those vibes that this was gonna be very dark theme, very, you know, vampire-ish type of thing, very Twilight in a way. So let's talk about the song and the video itself. I mean, I love the concept. Sonically so far, Josh is really making sure that he showcases the rapping skills, something that he is known for, especially with SB19. So I think that he wants to continue that path, you know, that route, and consolidate himself as a powerhouse in rap, especially when it comes here in the Philippines. So far already, he is giving us different looks, outfit changes, set changes. So I think that there is some budget and some effort put into the production of this music video so far. So I'm excited for the rest. I'll just go back a little bit and we can watch from there. Give us vocals! Wow, special. He's at the. Oh my god. Yo. It's getting hot in here. Wait long. Wait long. The last thing. Look, y'all, I got the chills. I cannot lie to you. I got the chills. That was genius. That was a perfect transition from rapping to singing to then dropping the beat. This makes me so, so excited because it means that we can expect the unexpected from Josh. He is not scared to play with the music, with the genres, to blend things. And honestly, so far, it's paying off. I love what I'm seeing and what I'm hearing as well. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna take a moment to address that. I think that I'm really happy that Josh is going this route because One of the things that maybe people don't give him as much credit within SB19 is his vocals. I mean, like his singing voice. Every time I hear like praise about Josh is, oh, the rapping skills and this and da da da. But so far with this music video, he is proving that he can rap, of course, we all know that. But he's also proving that he can sing by himself without having, you know, a bunch of people supporting him vocally. And that he can also dance. I mean, he's at the club quite literally, right? For me, that's so important, especially in the industry that he is trying to be successful. You know, P-pop is very competitive, and now SB19 being managed by a Korean company, those are things that are important for the boys to be very in control of. So far, this debut is giving me absolutely everything that I was expecting, and my baby looks so good. I mean, that's nothing new. Actually, I have a funny story about that, but I'll tell you later. Okay, let's keep watching now. He has that bad boy look. Wow, special effects, you know? I don't know where this club is, but I want to be there. Josh, if you're watching this, where's my invitation? I came from Manila. I came to Manila just for this. I'm available now. Okay, let me stop right there for a moment. Is the music video over? Wait, okay, no, there's more. So I'm just gonna stop for a second. I have a few things that I want to say. So I noticed, just listening to the song, and if you think about it, you know, everyone is talking about SB19 as a group, and then the individual boys, you know, in their solo projects. Of course, so far we have Josh that just released, we have Philip, we have Pablo as well. But when you think about it, even their solo projects are not so afar, not so apart from one another. When I think of Pablo, his entire project with La Luna had a very dark theme. You know, of course, there were so many different references to the moon and to the Wolfman, for example, being a monster. Here, Josh also is going for a very dark theme. Of course, we're talking about vampires, which are also closely linked to the moon. And I think that even if I think of Philip, let's say, in his music video for Rockstar, for example, let's just talk about that one. He kept on mentioning, you know, being like a monster, and, you know, it's a very dark theme. It's quite literally white and black, and it was very gore. Like, it seemed to have like a very heavy, dark message behind all of it, right? So let me know in the comment section. Am I just coming up with like fan theories and like conspiracies? But I think that in a way, their solo projects are still linked in a way. Maybe there's something going on behind the scenes, or is this just a coincidence? Maybe I'm going crazy. I don't know. The other thing that I wanted to tell you, actually, I hinted to this before, is that I actually have a funny story with Josh's mom. So, of course, I didn't post anything about the parents out of respect, but while I was here in the Philippines, I was invited to one of the events of the 18, and during this event, some of the parents of SB19 were there. So I got to meet the parents, take photos with them, of course, and I met Josh's mom. So when I go up to her, I tell her, oh, by the way, I'm such a fan of your son, like, I really love everything that he does, his work, and SB19, love that. And she looks at me and she's like, yeah, I remember you. I know you. You're the one who said that he's your bias. He's your asawa. Until you change your bias for Stel. Guys, when I told you that, my face cracked and I was so like, I was blushing at that point. And I just went like, you know, he's still my bias forever. I just love him as much. Of course, she was kidding. I was kidding as well. Of course, you know that when I say like my asawa and this and that, it's just for fun. But, you know, I respect the boys and all of that. Like, I appreciate them for the artistry and the music. Everything else is just jokes. But I thought that it was so fun that Josh's mom, quite literally his mom, was able to joke around with me and she got it. Like, she was so fun to meet. Same thing for the other parents. I actually got to meet Stell's parents and Justin's mom as well. So that was very interesting. Anyways, let's continue watching and let's wrap it up on one more minute of music video. Oh, we even get a bridge. We even get a bridge. Oh my God, Lord, global warming. Get this man, somebody, jail. Mm-mm. Global warming. Wow. I got the chills again. See, and it ends up with the moon. That's the end of it. Okay, wait long. Okay, let's talk about the music video so far. I mean, as I said earlier, I don't want to repeat myself too much, but the song, I love the song. It's so catchy and it gives me the perfect balance of everything that I love Josh for, you know? Great rap, great vocals, and he drops the beat so he's able to dance and give us, you know, like a fun dynamic moment. So no complaints. When it comes to the music video, I'm so happy, so pleased with the production. The company behind them is putting in the money in their projects, and I am so excited for that. But when you think of the music videos that we have been getting from Pablo, Josh, Philip, all of them had incredible production. So I'm extremely happy with that. I also appreciate the storytelling, you know, the entire vampire thing. Like, he wakes up, he's looking for his next victim, and then he ends up at the club just dancing the night away. I actually thought that at the end they were gonna come for him and kill him, but clearly, my king survived, right? Of course, that's my asawa. If someone tries to come for you, Josh, just call me. I'ma come with my tinelas, you know? I'ma defend you. You know that already, right? Anyways, go down in the comment section, guys. Let me know, what do you think about the music video, the visuals, the sound, my comments, feedback, anything that you want to express in the comment section down below. Don't forget to hit the like button on this video so that it gets recommended to more people, and subscribe to the channel for more content like this one almost every single day. I'll see you on the next one, and until then, stay safe, be kind to one another. Watch this video next if you want to be entertained. See you on the next one.